Hi guys, I'm going to show you how you can make a really good spring for the homemade hand engraving machine handpiece. Doesn't have to be this type, this is the one Rick made, but it applies to anyone, even if you're using the cheap screwdriver. The best spring to use is the springiest one you can possibly get. Yeah, I found the best ones I could get ready made were these type that were really meant for expansion, and they were made with the thinnest metal, and then you stretch them out and then make them a compression spring. But I think you could probably tell, so I'm pushing that and it's not going together, but you see this type, it goes together. I'll explain why that's important. You want one that moves with the least pressure and he's got a bit of travel, probably that much is all you need. And also you need to make them, although Rick's pistons have got this cut out, that's mainly to adjust the weight of the piston, but you think, oh yeah, I'd get a nice spring that fits in there. But this is made out of the same wire as this one, but I noticed the narrow one has more tension. See that? It's not, I'm kind of applying the same pressure to that as I do to this, and you can see, you know, that's right, that's quite a lot of pressure. I can close that up, but with this, I mean, because it's that shut, because it's thin, you can close it up, but it kind of goes to the side, so you imagine that would be doing that action inside the piston. But what you want to do is go for, so it applies to anything you're using as a handpiece, go for as wide as you can that fits. This one isn't that great, but this is the one I use, one that's as wide as you can. So even with this type of piston, it catches on that edge, so it still works and it saves you doing a longer piston. Right, so what I used is piano wire. It's 0.5mm piano wire, or music wire they call it, and it's tall steel, and I noticed this diameter comes hard already, which is to your advantage. And you're gonna, right, so this is in a rechargeable electric drill. You can just do it by hand, but it will look better under the video. And you need to experiment a bit. This rod is just under 6mm, so you'll notice I'll wind it round and then it will spring open. So you can just test a bit of if you're going to do this method, just get some, anything you can find, a bit of wood or anything that's round, and start off thinner than what you need, wind a bit around and then let it go, and then you'll see what diameter it's going to go to, and just keep going till you get something right. A drill bit is quite handy because you get a drill bit in all different lengths, but they're not long enough. You need something with a or the ones that I had, they didn't have quite enough room. So keep it as close together as you can, and you can stretch it out afterwards. It would be a good idea if you use gloves, because when this comes to the end, you've got a razor sharp bit of metal ready to spring around and put you off engraving for a few weeks. But I'll stop in time, or hold it with a pair of pliers on the end. But I find your thumb pressing against it makes the best. I should have cleaned this wire before I started, actually. It's a bit rusty, but it'll be okay. Right, it's coming to the end. Hang on. Oh no, it's not. No, I'll keep going to the end anyway. If you go off a little bit, I mean, obviously the neater you do it the better, but the other one I did, I tried to film it with camera glasses, it didn't work, so I couldn't see it that closely, but it wasn't perfect, but it still works okay. I'll try and use the whole wire. I don't think I need it much. I don't need it any longer, but I'll cut it down. While I'm at it, I'll use as much wire as I can, just so you can see. So a drill, like any kind of drill, it's got a, like the rechargeable drill's got a torque, so like a, oh, this bit's all crappy, but right, see, I'm coming to the, I'll let it go. Right, you got to be careful, that's got to whip around, so, oh, it did get me, never mind. No blood. So I got away lightly there, really. But right. So a drill bit, you'll find that there's not enough room to do all that. Never mind. Right, so you can see there, nice. So the idea is we'll stretch it out a bit. And that is, oh, that's the best one I've done so far. Where's my cutters? I may need to cut a little bit off of this, but yeah, it's a bit. This was the one I had working well. Maybe. So you can see this is slightly more tension than this one. That's going to work really well, yeah. Yeah, so obviously the neater you get it, because I've done it under the microscope, I've done it really neat, but yeah, right. I'll show you it work. Right, so I'm just going to put that in there. I may need slight adjustment. If you're getting the version with the adjustable screw at the back, it wouldn't matter so much. But what you can do is squeeze it down or cut a little bit off and then stretch it out. But let's get it going. Right. Oh yeah, I was going to cut the video, but we'll just do it, or we'll carry on. So the way I do it, keep winding it till it stops. Wind it down. All right, that's worked out. It's worked out really well, actually, I think. Oh yeah, that's it. When you're adjusting it, push. Make sure the see, that gets knocked out. Make sure that's pushed in when you're setting your right. Now let me show you why a soft spring is what you want to try and aim for. Right, you can see that what you can see there through the here, that hole, is the edge of the piston, and then you can see the little bit of protrusion that hits the back of the quick change fitting. Now, the softer the spring, the less effort or the less air you need to get the piston moving. So that equates to finer control. You have a greater range of acceleration. So you're going to start off, let's do it. I think I could probably get this even better, because the one I had before, it was actually oscillating before I pushed the pedal, which was the slight bit of air that's leaking through my wooden foot pedal was enough to get it moving, but it didn't matter because it wasn't moving enough to I'll tell you what, I'll change to my other one. I'm gonna work on this one a bit more. I think I need to cut a tiny little bit off of it, but I'll change to this one. So you can see, even though you don't have to make a brilliant job, and you've ended up with a really good spring, which you have a job to find. I mean, I managed to get a correct dimensions for my other handpiece, but then the steel was too stiff. So you either get the right thickness of metal if you get a ready-made spring, or it's not the right dimensions. So making your own one, and all it costs you is a bit of a wound, right? If you're stupid. I don't know if that's it. I think I put the wrong spring in. Right, that was the wrong spring. Right. I think. I've got so many flipping springs around now, I don't know where I'm coming or going. Oh, we'll go back to that one. That seems to work better than the... Right, I'll just explain what to look for, and then you need to... Focus... Why won't it focus, you fool? What the hell? Oh, right. Is it working? Yeah. It's focusing on my macro lens with all the scratches on it. Right, let me stop. Right, so the benefit of a softer spring, whatever the right expression is, the piston will start moving at a slower speed, or a lighter air flow, and also because it's soft, it will compress more. So you have a range of power, whatever you need for any task you're engraving, but you also, because right, the action is it's a tiny amount of air, and the spring is right, this is the piston, my finger is going to be the piston, it's got a tiny amount of air and it's pumping away there. Then it's got a lot of air and it's squashing the spring and firing back. So the analogy is a hammer. So the hammer's tap, 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 and then you give it some. You've got the same little hammer, but you're moving it a greater distance, which is creating more force. So it turns, if your handpiece is running erratic or it's not very powerful, you do a spring like that. So it's 0.5 mil. Piano wire, music wire, tool steel wire. You can, if you're dying to get going and you're kind of waiting for an order, or you haven't got very good access to tool steel wire, you can make one from, you can make one from copper. What I did, and it is surprisingly, you can tension. That's quite, that is actually more tension than the other spring. There's a, this is probably about the same diameter, 0.5 mil, and that's pretty good. That's, you can see there, it's closing and it's springing, and the more you use that, the harder it would get. The way I did it is, so you probably get this kind of wire out of some coax or something like that, you'd be able to find it. You get a long, right, imagine it's a straight bit. It shows you it's not that great, it doesn't hold it much tension, but for our purposes it would work. So you get a long straight bit of wire. If you look carefully, you can see that's got all spiraled up. What I did is held one end in a vise, put the other end in the rechargeable drill, and just wind it up and keep winding it and winding it. What you're doing, you're creating your work hardening the wire, and you are actually, it's not tempering it, but you're making the equivalent of tempering copper. Then do the spring process like what I did. You know, it's still bendy, but that's quite stiff, and obviously you don't, some will say it wouldn't be possible, but there you can see it is possible to make a spring, and that would work. I made those using the same method. You'd probably get away with that, but you know, I had some tall steel wire, so I did that. Hope that helps, guys. Cheers, everybody. Bye.